Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Friend, I am truly sad to bring this to your awareness. It does not lift me up in any way. It does not make me joyful. It does not make me happy. Telling you this, I didn't want to have to be the bearer of bad news because this very thing is affecting the people I love. I mean, people who I love. It's beyond just the producer community. Now these social media hacks are now attacking the people I love, and I feel like it's my responsibility as a person to protect the people I love, including the producer community. I love you guys, but I love some people even more than I love you guys, and it's now getting to them. So now I have to make this a public announcement, which I didn't want to have to do. And the things you're going to hear today will shock you. The things you're going to hear today may create enemies for you. And again, I'm not here to, you know, make anybody else's business suffer. That's not the goal. The goal is to protect my people, period. That's my goal. As a man, I cannot sit back any longer and watch this stuff happen because it's making people get depressed long term. When you have a dream and you're following somebody that says they're going to guide you to a dream and then they really just guide you into a pit of darkness, then you become depressed thinking that your dream was just false, when in reality, you were just led by the wrong person. And again, I deeply do not want to tell you this type of stuff. It's not motivating. It's not inspiring. But it's to the point where if I don't say anything, I'm not doing my job. And I will feel even worse if I didn't tell you, because when you find out, then you're going to blame me for not telling you. Okay. So today I want to reveal some tools and really dark, manipulative things people are using in today's world to manipulate the idea of effectiveness. Now, we're going to break it down into a lot of layers. But I want to thank MG The Future for one, and I want to thank Craftmaster Productions for bringing this to my attention, because I didn't know about the site. Okay, I didn't know about these sites. I didn't know the exact name of the site. I knew what was going on, but I didn't know the exact name. So I want to thank them for bringing this to my awareness, because I'm seeing it in other places like Instagram. And it's really bothering me, okay? It's getting to the point where I have to say something. So, without further ado, let's start with this site here. Again, this is a site where it's called SM Zeus. I do not recommend this at all, okay? I got this site from MG The Future and Craftmaster Production. So, SM Zeus is a site where... Now, let's read it word for word so I don't make up any opinions because I've never used the site. But firstly, it says, crush your competition. Then the subheadline says, whether we like it or not, there is a war commencing on social media. Ever wondered how your competitors are getting so many more views, likes, and followers than you? Did you wonder how they can easily rank videos on YouTube and get their videos suggested to millions? Here at smzeus.com, we know the deal, and we know how to crush your competition. Don't get left behind. Sign up today. So they're promising you a position against your competitors by manipulating the numbers of social media. And they offer services for YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, SoundCloud, and much more. So firstly, let me make you aware of the things people can do with these tools so that you understand the foundation. And again, it disheartens me tremendously to share this information because I never want to bring light to the darkness. But it's to the point where people don't know it's a darkness, okay? And they think it's okay, and it's not. So firstly, what people can buy. So you would never think this. You can buy live stream viewers on Instagram. Did you know that? So whenever you see on Instagram, somebody starts a live and magically there's 300 and some people off the rip before the notification even went out, they're probably using tools like this. Have you ever noticed people's, it's more obvious when we get into Instagram, like their likes go from 6 likes an hour or after 2 hours. I've even watched this with people I love. Again, my goal is to protect the people I love. But I've seen people advising the people I love their own posts. Now, they position themselves as social media managers and they put a post up. The thing had 6 likes for 3 hours, 4 hours. I go back in the fourth hour, it has 3,900 and something likes. Now, I understand people buying likes. It's not the biggest offense. It's still an offense, but it's not the biggest offense. But what's offensive is that you're leading my people into thinking you're going to guide them to a dream because of the results that you fake. So you're ultimately lying to my family and my loved ones. Okay, that's the problem. It's not that you're buying likes for your own ego. It's that you're telling people that you're effective enough to get these likes organically when it's a complete lie. And I would never have anybody I love follow somebody who's a complete liar and a complete fraud. We're gonna get into it. I'm just touching the surface. We haven't even really started the video yet. But a site like this, I'm sure you've seen Twitter retweets. Okay, that stuff is kind of obvious. On YouTube, how do you spot a fake? Well, let's get into how to spot a fake a little bit later. So I'm gonna reveal how to spot fake views and fake likes and fake all that type of stuff. It used to be a different system, but okay, so people are buying this stuff and faking it. And again, you can fake comments. So you can go in there and make it look organic by people commenting. Because usually people say, how does he have 1,000 likes with zero comments? Okay, but there's a way people fake comments that look real, like fire, or they'll put like certain general phrases, but it applies to the post. So it looks like there's a lot more engagement than there really is. Okay, and the people use this to manipulate the perception, because perception is reality. Okay, if you see somebody walking down the street with a bunch of body armor on, but in reality, it's just a holograph, you're going to freak out because you think they have a bunch of body armor on, when in reality, they're wearing boxer shorts. Okay, so let's talk about the legalities behind this. Okay, so FTC, something you have to get very familiar with if you're running an online business. And I see the music producer community not following compliance all the time. And again, I'm not here to be, you know, a stickler. I'm here to just make stuff aware to you, okay? Because there's certain reasons why you see certain people doing perceived better in a certain area, okay? Because, okay, anyway, I'm not gonna get into all the little stuff, but FTC. So let's talk about fake likes. Now it says endorsements by individuals on social networking sites. So this talks about if you are promoting a product for another company, you have to disclose that you're promoting the product and you were paid to do it. It's called an endorsement. Okay, now if you do not disclose that you are being paid to promote a product, you are insinuating that you yourself bought the product and use it and love it. And you're telling other people that it's a good product. So you're deceiving people into thinking that the product is more effective than it is because you're not revealing to them that you were paid to talk about that product. So that's a number one offense I see all over social media, let alone the producer community. A second offense here is that people are like, oh, this is fake likes, it's harmless. If you read this, it says, however, I'm reading directly from the FTC compliance questionnaire. So it says, however, an advertiser buying fake likes is very different from an advertiser buying fake likes is very different from an advertiser offering incentives for likes from actual customers. So for example, they want you to stray away from forcing people to do something for something because you're creating a deceptive thing. You're saying, go like this thing that you really don't like in order to download this free thing. Okay, it's deceptive practices. If likes are from non-existent people, which is what like bots are, like sites like these have robots, computers, fake user accounts that go in and create all these comments for you, create all the likes and create all the fluff. Okay, so it says if likes are from non-existent people or people who have no experience using the product or service, this is an even bigger key. Okay, so it's you can say, oh, their Instagram is real, it's a real Instagram account, when in reality it's a computer generated account or made by some person in a different country who made 7 accounts and used their picture to make it look real. So even if you go beyond the non-existent portion, it says or people who have no experience using the product or service. Okay, so let's read this from the beginning. If likes are from non-existent people or people who have no experience using the product or service, they are clearly deceptive, and both the purchaser and the seller of the fake likes could face enforcement action. Again, I'm not wishing any death upon anybody. The point is to tell my people, this is an offense, okay? It's in law, it's an offense, okay? I'm not making this stuff up. Buying fake likes is doing that very thing. You're making people think that your product is more effective than it is so that they're more persuaded to buy the product. You're lying to then make people think that it's an okay thing. It's very similar to how clubs, make you wait outside in a big line. Now, this is a completely legal thing to do, but they make you wait outside in that long line, and really, there's nobody in the club. They want you in that line because it makes the club look like it's popping so that more people get in line. That's the point of the line outside the club. And the same thing goes on during social media. People create a fake line. It's called priming the pump. And I've gone to school at Villanova University. I've been around a lot of business students. And the number one thing I kept hearing was them trying to fake the numbers going in to make it have more social proof than it actually had. And, you know, that was like a strategy they tried to use. And they called it priming the pump. So I want you to be very, very clear on what people are doing and that it's a complete offense. Okay, it's right here in the FTC law. Okay, it's deception. And I don't want to be around people who deceive people into thinking they're more effective than they are. And it's not just about my opinion. I'll get into what I mean in a second. All right, so I had to pause the video to find more information for you. I couldn't find the exact information and article from the FTC that I read. But here's a quick entry on a website from an attorney at law. Again, I would really dig deeper to find the exact article. It just might take me too long, because this message is too real for me to sit here for 3 hours trying to find an article. But the point is, another way people are kind of, again, not abiding by these rules and playing outside the realm of rules, the reason you see people succeeding so much or so quickly is because they're probably breaking some type of rule, okay? That's usually the key. So here's one more thing you might overlook, which is creating a lottery through a giveaway. So some people make you buy something in order to enter a giveaway. That's considered a lottery. It's like buying a lottery ticket. You're buying a ticket to hopefully win this thing, and you're spending money to do it. Now, in a giveaway, you're supposed to state that there's no purchase required, and you're supposed to make that very apparent. Okay, that's like the number one thing you're supposed to do, is say no purchase required to enter. Okay, so that's another thing that people are doing to kind of scale up quickly, but they're, you know, not following the guidelines. Okay, so aside from fake likes, it goes deeper. That's why I said we're barely touching the surface. We're on line 3 of about 10 of my notes right now. Okay, so there's a lot more to it. So next, I want to focus on how to spot fake stuff. Okay, if you're on Instagram, the easiest way is to see the like to comment ratio, and also to see the like, what's the word I can use for it? The consistency throughout the hours. So if it's the first hour and it doesn't have 100 likes, but by the fourth hour it has 3,500 likes, you know it's fake. Okay. And the only reason I'm telling you that is not so you can go point out everybody who has a fake like thing on their Instagram. It's to say, never follow the people giving you advice on social media management, PR, business advice, you know, advertising. Never follow their advice. If they use any of these techniques, never, ever follow any piece of advice these people give you. They're fraudulently giving you results. And any real marketer always presents their results first. They never talk about the fluff. They always present the results. If I'm hiring somebody to do Facebook ads, show me the reports of your ROI from day 1 to day 90. Show me all your campaigns. Show me all the successful stuff that actually worked and brought in real money, not, you know, fluff. Okay, so I'm not telling you this to go point out everybody on Instagram. I'm telling you this to avoid the wolves in sheep's clothing. Liars, deceptive people using deceptive practices to create an illusion. And you're only destroying your dream by following these people. And you're going to be more depressed and more misled if you keep following these people. And it really does bother me. Okay, I really didn't want to have to come to this point, but I have to make this video for you all. So how else do you spot fakeness? I said Instagram. Let's go back to the site, the Zeus site. So let's go thing by thing. So YouTube, the easiest way to spot fakeness on YouTube is the view to like ratio. Usually speaking, for every 1,000 views, you're going to get about, usually it's 1 to 10. But it depends, okay? I'm not always saying this. So if you get 1,000 views, usually you have 100 likes. That's how it used to be. But now, currently, and today, I would say even 1 to 100, meaning if you get 1,000 views, you should have at least 10 likes, okay? That's usually how it works. It depends on your... I have videos that have you know, 100,000 views, but have maybe like 500 likes. But then I also have a video with 5,000 views that has like 560 likes. So it really changes depending on your audience and their engagement in the moment. Okay, but that's the quickest way to spot fakes on YouTube. Another quick way is their dislikes. So if somebody has 200 likes and zero dislikes, you know, for like 30,000 views, it's automatically fake. You already know, because the law of averages will eventually show you that people would dislike it over that many people. Not everybody's going to love it. And also the comments. So if you have, again, 30,000 views, 200 likes, zero dislikes, and like two comments, you know it's fake. Somebody bought views somewhere and it's just completely fraudulent. So again, it's not to go be a person who goes to point out people. It's to say, if somebody ever comes to you saying they can be your social media manager, because this seems to be the new wave on the internet, how to make money. I don't know if everybody went through some course or something, but everybody feels like they can be a social media manager all of a sudden, when in reality, their own social media is garbage. And the stuff they do is trash and deceptive. So I want to really protect you from these people, these frauds. Okay. Moving forward. Okay. So we said YouTube. Facebook, I haven't been on Facebook very often. Facebook is a different game now. It's not really the same. You know, I have, 50,000 likes, and I put out a post on Facebook, it might get 20 likes. You know, it doesn't really correlate because they're blocking your reach from all your people. So they're not even giving the post to everybody. Everybody doesn't see that post. So Facebook's a little bit different in the way they present your information, whereas YouTube, it shows your stuff on the feed regardless. But Facebook, you may not even see the post that you put out on the feed. So Facebook spotting a fake is a little bit different. I would just say when the sales don't match up, I would just really not even look at Facebook as a way to determine if somebody's real or fake. But usually comments are the greatest indicator, okay, of engagement on Facebook. But Instagram is very obvious. Again, consistency of likes. If you have 6 likes for 3 hours and then the fifth hour you have 3,000, complete lie. Okay, if you have 1,900 likes on a picture that just came out 2 hours ago and zero comments, unless you turned off your comments, complete lie. So here's another thing. On Instagram, you can actually turn off comments for a post. So I wouldn't always say that just because they have zero comments means it's fake. You want to look at if they only have one comment or two comments, okay? Because if that many people are seeing it, the law of averages is going to increase the number of people who are willing to write comments. So it's just clearly, you know. Another way on Instagram, another sneaky way is go to their followers, and I want you to scroll down for a little bit. So the top people are going to be people you probably think are mutual, or how the algorithm determines you might like the other people. Now, once you scroll past the people that are real people, you're going to start seeing people from different countries. So click on those people from different countries and look at how many people they're following. And when you click on their account and you see it's, you know, whoever from India and or not even India, the Philippines, you click on their account. And then they're following 7,000 people, but they only have 20 followers. And then you go to the next person in their follower list, and then you see that they're also following 8,000 people. Again, these could be real people. Maybe there's a site that pays people to follow people. I don't know. But it's fake. It's fakeness. Okay? It could be a real person, but it's fakeness. All right? So I really want you to understand. These are keys to understanding how people have fake followings. And running advertisements, I can tell you that sometimes you do get fake accounts that follow you. So just because somebody has one person who has the 8,000 following doesn't mean that their whole account is fake. It's just, I don't know what it is about advertisement, but there's, I guess, a piece in there that attracts those fake accounts to your thing, and you can't stop it from following you. So, I mean, I understand that, but these are people who don't run ads, who just magically all of a sudden have 3,000 likes, nobody in the comments. That's very obvious. All these clues will let you know. So if you ever have a social media manager, a PR person, an advertising person, a marketing person come to you and tell you they can manage your career and handle your social media, and you put all your trust in their hands, I want you to look at all this stuff and really ask yourself, is this real? Okay, and that's the most disheartening thing, because once you understand it's not real and you put all your faith in this person, it might break you. So that's why I didn't want to make this video, but I have to at this point. Okay? Twitter. All the signs can basically be compiled across all the platforms. It's about views, like ratio, and then comments, but also looking at their followers to see if they're real or not. Now, some of these platforms might be a little more cloudy to kind of see. Like, for example, Facebook, Twitter, and SoundCloud might be a little more cloudy as to see how many people were actual followers. Now, again, all the companies you see who are perceived popping, they used a lot of stuff that broke the terms and conditions of these social media platforms. There used to be a site called Artist Union. The reason that site is not up anymore is because they were using, people were using it against the terms and policies of the companies. So they were doing it falsely. They were cheating their way up. Okay. So that's why I'm saying don't put your confidence in somebody who used cheats to get to where they are. That's why I never really understood why people give so much admiration to people who cheated their way into the music industry, you know, illegally or however they got their money up and then made a success. But in the reality, they cheated their way in. I don't understand that. But that's my own opinion. It's not really anything that could persuade you here. But moving forward, there's more. Okay, we're only on line four. And again, I did not want to make this video, but I have to at this point. The next thing is called Black Hat SEO. Black Hat SEO uses unethical means of gaining traffic or bringing people to your thing. So for example, on YouTube, in the terms, it says you're not allowed to put keywords in the video descriptions, for example. So whenever you see somebody with like a bunch of keywords stacked on top of each other, and it's just a bunch of keywords, that's technically against the terms and conditions. Okay, so that would be something like Black Hat SEO, going against the rules to get more traffic or persuade the algorithm in your favor. But Black Hat SEO goes so much deeper. It goes into dark traffic sources. Like, for example, when you go to a website and it kind of like reloads for a second and runs an ad and reloads and does all this weird stuff, and then you finally get to the website, that would be Black Hat SEO. It's creating a false impression on a piece of content when nobody even saw the piece of content. And it's making people think that they're getting likes and views, but in reality, it's all fake and computerized. And there used to be, I'm not a coder, but from what I understand, coders used to embed videos and embed content in the website, but it was like invisible. So you couldn't see it, but it was there. So every time somebody visited the website, it would, you know, count as a viewer or whatever. You've also seen those little fake download buttons, another one, you know, deceptive practice. So this is what I mean about Black Hat SEO, very dark, deceptive practices. Another thing you want to look into, I'm not going to really dig into it, but private blog networks, PBNs, okay? It's the equivalent, basically, of buying likes. It's making the perception that people are really covering you in the blog world, but in reality, you're just paying to be across these blogs, okay? Now, let me see if I get to this in my notes. Consequences of faking. So here's what's next. Consequences of faking, social media marketer frauds, guidelines to choose managers. And let me get to the end point right now. Okay. So here's what they do. Here's the whole game. You wonder how they make money. Here's how they do it. These PR agents and social media managers and all these fraudulent advertisers. What they do is they make you pay them to pay your way into opportunity. So for example, a site like this, let's say your agent charges you. And I say agent with the biggest quotations in the world, because half these kids are agents. Which makes me laugh. Okay. Let's say they make you pay them $300 a month. Now, I don't know how much this stuff costs, and I'm not here to investigate the site. The point is, for on this site, let's say you can get a bunch of results for 300. Let's say you can get 30,000 views on YouTube for 300 bucks. So what they'll do is they'll spend 50. How much is 300 divided by? Let's say 100 bucks every week they'll spend on YouTube views. So it looks like a consistent growth. And then they'll say, see, I'm bringing you the results you want. So you keep paying them. They might take a small net profit for the first couple months, but they make you think that they're getting the results. And then over time, you pay them more and more and more, and they just take whatever the difference is between what they spent on these websites and what they charge. And they just put that in their pocket. It's fraudulent. It's completely fraudulent. It's making somebody think they're getting results when in reality, they're just using your money to buy services that you can buy yourself, but it's still deceptive. So that's their whole game and scheme. And the whole world of PR, social media management is smoke and mirrors. And I really want you to understand that. So let me go back to the top. Black Hat SEO, private blog networks. Here are some consequences of faking it. Okay. Now, again, this has nothing to do with my opinion. This has what has to do with you. So, firstly, if you are, let's say you do give somebody control over your YouTube channel, for example, and they use services like this to boost up your views and likes, the algorithm will punish you beyond belief to where you might not even recover. Okay, so you're automatically putting your whole existence online at risk because you wanted to deal with a person who was being fraudulent and deceptive. So that's the number one thing. You can be penalized beyond the grave, internet speaking. So you can put your whole brand at risk because somebody decided to use deceptive practices. That's one thing. Algorithm penalties are very real. And when you break their terms, they do not take that lightly at all. And if they don't send you a letter through your email, they will definitely make you aware via your engagement on your content and make you basically undiscoverable. Okay? Now here's another consequence of faking. Advertisement and what I can't read my own notes here. Advertisement and something lookalike audience. I don't know what else I wrote here, but I'll probably figure it out. Looks like mask or wax. I don't know what that says. But advertisements and oh, ads maybe. I don't know what that says. But when you run ads, there are things called lookalike audiences. These are, so let's say you buy a bunch of fake views for your Facebook or whatever videos. Okay? Now, when it's time to run advertisements, you have an audience, it's called, on Facebook Ad Manager. Now, you're running ads to that audience. So you're spending real money to now promote to robots. Okay? And on top of that, you have what's called a lookalike audience. So you have an audience that mirrors the audience that you already have. So if your whole audience is a bunch of bots and fakeness, and then you go to run a lookalike audience, Facebook's just gonna look at the characteristics of all the bots that you've have following you and then run your advertisements to more bots. Okay? So you're really just wasting your money completely and losing money on top of that. And the number one rule in investment is never lose money, period. And you're automatically losing money because you started off with false perception. Now, another consequence of faking is, let's say, sponsorship deals. People or bigger companies come to you for sponsorship deals, and this happens all the time in modeling because I mentor models and I see this all the time with agencies. Let's say models buy fake likes for agencies because the clients book on numbers. So for example, if BusyWorks Beats as a client goes to a model agency in Kentucky and I need certain models to be at NAMM or do something cool with the company. Okay, so I go to that agency and I say, not only do I want somebody that looks good as a model or fits the profile of my audience as the model, but I also want them to have a social media influence to spread the word. So what I'll do as BusyWorks Beats as a client, go to the Kentucky modeling agency and I'll look at the people with the top followers. But in reality, they have fake followers. So I'm spending more money to get somebody with 2 million followers, even though 1 million are fake. Okay? So I'm going to somebody with 2 million followers to, spend my money with them because they have 2 million followers. And it must be good because they have 2 million followers, but it's all fake. So I'm spending a lot more money for less result. And then at the end of the day, when I go to sell my product, let's say a sponsorship. Okay, so let's say, what's a gaming company? Let's say Fortnite or some big company comes to you as a streamer, a gamer, and you faked all your numbers. Now they come to you and they pay you $1,000 per video. Okay, so now you make the video and you make it clear that they endorsed you and everything. And then at the end of the day, you didn't sell any more copies of Fortnite for them. So now they're looking at you like they just lost money. And now they're never going to come back to you again because you have terrible results. You don't have real people that you're driving to their websites to really buy things with real sales. Okay, it's all fraudulent traffic. So now they figure out they're not going to invest in you anymore. And now your name has a bad reputation. Okay, so that's the real consequence of faking it out here. It's not just somebody spotting that you have a fake Gucci belt on. It's real consequences out here. So moving forward, there's more. Okay, so again, I don't know who's training these people to think they're social media marketers or social media managers or PR agents or whatever course these people took. Social media marketers and frauds and PRs. Okay, here's a guideline how to choose managers or PR agents. Here's a couple guidelines to help you make you understand that they're real. For one, all marketers work on results only. That's the only proof they have is their result. So if they don't show you the result, then they're probably lying to you or don't want you to understand that they're not skilled. So here are a couple things you can do. I want you to ask the person for three qualified client testimonials, not just three clients that they've worked with and pictures with them, but testimonials. I want you to talk to them or hear a video where they go through and tell you about their experience with that person from three different people. It's similar to, you know, how America works. You can't just say somebody did something without a witness. You need more witnesses here. Okay. So the next one is make sure they have reports showing the money that they generated or the result that you're looking for. Sometimes it's not always money, so I'll leave that open, but money is usually generated through these services. So I want them to show you real reports showing the money they generated. And people can even fudge that, okay? And maybe one day I'll show you how people lie to you about their PayPal balances and Shopify balances and all this type of stuff. Maybe one day I'll expose that to you, but I don't want to break your motivation right now, okay? So the third thing is to make sure they actually have engaging followings. Why follow somebody who does not even have an engaging following, okay? They may have 20,000 followers on their Instagram and 3,000 likes on their pictures after 4 hours magically from going from 6 likes to 3,000, but then nobody comments, okay? So that lets you know it's not real, okay? So if you don't see engagement, again, it's not real. Now here, you can even buy custom comments. So even then, it becomes a thing that you really have to dig deeper to find. That's why I said don't rely on just engaging factors or the reports, because people can lie on reports. People can even lie with their engagement with their communities. Now, lastly, this should be the number one thing. I want you to require from them 10 successful ad campaigns and reports with the return on investment. So that's where they can't BS, okay? Because real ad campaigns, especially multiple ad campaigns, if you compare them to each other, are not gonna be similar. So if you spend $100 on one ad and spend $100 on the next, you're not gonna get the same numbers. It's not gonna look similar. It's gonna have variation. And when you see variation, you're gonna realize that it's real. Okay, those are just a couple things you can do before you ever hire a PR agent, a social media management, a social media advertiser. Okay, now lastly, PR agents make you pay them to pay your way into opportunities. Again, Craftmaster and MG The Future made this very clear about the things people would do for live shows. Craftmaster explained it in his live stream with MG. Okay, but what they'll make you do is pay for opportunities. So here's the big illusion that I want you to understand. Whenever you see people doing interviews for certain companies, they probably paid to be on that show. So it's not like they earned their way onto the show. So what's the big deal? If you have money, you can get on the show too. There's no real big deal about it. That's why I never understood why people were so excited to be on the radio. Anybody can advertise on the radio. If you have a budget, you know, anybody can be on TV. If you have a budget, you pay the money and you get in front of certain people. That's why whenever you see a movie coming out, let's say a Kevin Hart movie, and you wonder why Kevin Hart's movies are running on TBS and FX and all the channels. That's promotion for the movie coming up. You wonder why Kevin Hart shows up on the night shows, the late night shows. You wonder why Kevin Hart shows up on the morning shows. You wonder why Kevin Hart does little skits for Wildin' Out. It's because he's about to promote whatever's coming out. And all that money is invested in him going on those shows. That's how those shows make money for the most part. They run ads with advertisers, and that's considered an advertisement. When somebody pays to be interviewed by your company. Okay, it's called marketing. Okay, so I don't want you to think that these things are so grandiose because it's all paid for. It's all one big illusion. There's no way you earn this. Now, in some cases, people do earn it, but when you're in the big machine like that, it's about scalability and it's about your budgets and different things. So that's why I want you to understand you can get caught up in this so easy thinking that it's real. But that's all I have to say. Again, I made this video not to be a pessimist. I want to really reveal these things because it's been weighing on my heart for probably 4 weeks to about 2 months right now. And I even had a deep conversation with MG The Future. He can tell you that I asked him, I said, this is happening to people I love. And I can't sit back and watch this happen. You know, should I say something or will that potentially create, you know, fission or that's not the word. Yeah, fission or friction between me and that person. And I said, should I take the risk? Because I know the consequences of this thing. And if I don't say something, the consequences greatly outweigh whatever would come if I said the right thing. And in the moment, there was friction. Okay. So you have to understand that I'm even taking the risk making this super public. Okay, I'm taking a very big risk making this public. And I didn't want to, but now I have to, because it's at the point where now the people I love are being deceived into snares, into traps, into lies, into deception. And they're being fed this dream that if they just hang on with this person, they'll get to their dreams. And it's such a lie and a fraudulence. And I cannot stand here any longer and watch it happen, okay, with my awareness. So hopefully you understand the sincerity of this video. Again, stay away from any get rich quick stuff. Stay away from any get famous quick stuff. Stay away from any buying likes, views, and comments. Advertising is fine, but this type of stuff, not cool. Okay, you even went through the rules and regulations of it all. And stay away from just stuff that's deceptive. Stop trying to deceive people, okay? So hopefully this changed your life. Again, I don't know how you're going to react, but please let me know in the comments below how you feel about this, because I truly want to know if I pulled down any like walls of mystery, because I don't want to shatter people's dreams by showing them the reality. It's kind of like pulling back the curtain. I don't want to be that person. Okay, but hopefully you took this more as a protective thing than me trying to shatter the idea that Santa Claus doesn't exist, so to speak. Okay, so let me know how you feel, because again, I'm taking a deep risk. It's Game from BusyWorksBeats.com.